Before I start, who of you already knew CBI before before coming here, before seeing the agenda? Okay, that's quite a few. And how many of you also knew what we do? It's about the same. Okay, that's about half of the room. So it makes sense to explain you a little bit, I guess, about CBI, what we do. Then I'll show you a bit about the actual trade between Colombia and Europe, although a lot of that has already been covered by Jan and Jan Willem, so I'll go through that quickly. And then I'll explain a bit about what we're doing with the Colombian companies that we're supporting at the moment, their challenges, strategies that we're implementing with them, the challenges they face. So first, CBI. CBI was established 40 years ago by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs here in the Netherlands as an, well, I think first as a center or a department, and then became an independent agency in 1998. We're here in The Hague at the Beatrix Quarter. We used to be in Rotterdam for a long time, but we moved to The Hague 2 months ago, where we have about 60 staff. I'm one of them. I'm in the Latin America team. The staff that is here in the office are mostly program managers, logistics managers, and apart from the staff, we have a network of about 250 experts all around Europe, actually all around the world. And those are the experts that are either experts in their particular product, say fresh fruit and vegetables, or car parts, or medical tourism, to say to give an example, or market researchers or trainers. So those are the experts that that we actually use in our programs. We have one of them here with us today. Actually, Juliana is also working in one of our programs that I'll tell you about a little later. We have an annual budget of about 25 million euros. Give you an idea of the size of the organization, working in some 40 countries. And our mission is, as Juliana already said, to contribute to sustainable economic development in developing countries through the expansion of exports from those countries. And there we don't only focus on the Netherlands, but basically on the entire European market. So our vision is to be the expert in export development and promotion from developing countries. Our focus is to the SME exporters and to strengthen their competitiveness on the European market. We do that not just between us and the SMEs, but with a large network of exports, a network among importers here in Europe, a network of what we call business support organizations, and in Colombia we're working a lot with ProExport, the National Trade and Tourism Investment Promotion Organization. We don't have local offices in the countries that we work in, so we work a lot with those organizations like ProExport to organize our activities, to promote our programs, to implement our programs. We use an integrated approach, and by that we mean we don't only work with the exporters themselves, but we also try to work on the what we call the enabling environment for these exporters. So the institutions around the exporters, ProExport, for example, help them to improve their services to their clients. Work with the governments if it is necessary to improve the environment in which the exporters converge. And in the end, because we are an instrument of the Dutch development aid, which will eventually stop, what we do, what we want to do by this working on the environment is to make sure that someone will take over after we leave. And I'm sure that that will happen in the, within the next 10 years when it comes to Colombia, because Colombia might not be, will not be a developed country for long. So that is how we prepare for that period, working with organizations like ProExport to make sure they can help the exporters of Colombia to flourish on the foreign markets. We do that not by giving money or giving credit, but by providing advice, counseling, and knowledge, basically, about the European markets, training, coaching, consultancy. And well, corporate social responsibility is actually becoming very important, and there's no program or project in which we do not have a CSR component anymore. First of all, because that's it's a good thing to do, but more importantly, perhaps because it's what the European consumers and businesses are asking and demanding. So that's what the exporters who want to export to Europe need to know and need to comply with. Well, our programs consist of basically four types of what we call our modules. Export coaching, ECP modules, is what I would say the backbone of all our programs. Coaching for exporters, in which we take them usually through a process of about 5 years, where they start with the company, do a company audit, then take them through a whole preparation period where we prepare them for the European market, prepare them to adapt their processes or adapt their products to European tastes, adapt or support them to select a particular market in Europe, because talking about Europe is really talking about 27 different markets and cultures. So we help them to select a particular market where they can best allocate their products or services. We help them to select the best product of their product range. And then when they're ready, when they've complied with the criteria, when they've got the standards, or when they comply with the standards, or they've got the certifications, we take them to the market. We take them to fairs, we take them to matchmaking activities. So that's the expert coaching. Apart from that, as I said, we work with institutions. Again, I'm giving the example for Export, because that's just so, such an important institution for us in Colombia, where we work on what we call business support organization development, BSOD. A third component in all our projects is market information, and that you will actually find on our website. A lot of market studies about, well, you name it. If you want to know the French market for wood products or door frames, you can look at our website and select France, timber products, and you'll find the trends and the opportunities in the French market for door frames, or the Spanish market for exotic fruits. You go to our website, select tropical fruits and vegetables, Spain, and there you'll find not only the trends and the opportunities, but also all the requirements, because Europe is a difficult market, has a lot of legal requirements, and apart from that, a lot of private standards that companies and importers impose on the exporters. So what we try to do, we cannot change that in most cases. So what we try to do is we list all those requirements, we try to make sense of it for the exporters that often cannot see the tree from the woods or the woods from the tree. So that is what we do in that in those market information products that you can all access actually on our website. And the final component of all our products or our programs is human resource development, in which we train people in companies or in institutions on anything related to export or the European markets. So how to behave on trade fairs, how to deal with European clients, how to cost or price your product, how to do market research, how to implement corporate social responsibility in your company, all those export-related issues. Well, I told you a bit about our export coaching process already, so I won't go through all of this, but basically these are this is the type of assistance that we provide for the company. So we start from a business audit, we make an action plan with the company, we take them through the stage of business development if they need it, because not all companies need that, especially in Colombia, there's a lot of companies that don't need to work on their business development, they're already at a quite high level where they can start directly to build their export capacity, get the right certifications, and then enter the European market, or in some cases, regional market, but that's a fairly new service that we provide and haven't tried very much yet. Actually, I also had a quiz. I'm not very original. This is what I was going to show here is that still a lot of the Colombian exports are in traditional products. Actually, 88%, so almost all products are in four major categories. And I was going to ask you which was the first product group that takes up more than half of all exports. Sure you know now. Coal, exactly. Well, the second one then, the 21%. Flowers is among them, but not among the 21%.
Coffee.
Banana. It's the bananas. Well, the edible fruits and nuts, but most of that is really bananas. Coffee. This is 2010, by the way. Coffee and spices is the category, but most of it is really coffee. It's 8%. Then iron and steel, 5%. And this is to Europe, right? Not just to the Netherlands, not to the world, but to the European market. And 2% is flowers. So it's still quite concentrated in a few products. This is not where we work or put most of our effort. We try to work on the 12% to get the non-traditional exports going. So these are the markets that actually buy Colombian products in Europe. I guess you already saw what the biggest buyer is, or who the biggest buyer is. Germany, the second one, I guess you know by now after Jan Willem and Jan's presentations. Exactly, the Netherlands. And then we've got the UK, Belgium, Italy, Spain, and France. Those are really the major buyers of Colombian products. And then if you look at what they buy, it's again those same products. In the case of the Netherlands, it's really 80% minerals or coal. Belgium, on the other hand, takes up a large proportion of the fruits. Of course, this is all transit because Belgians don't eat that much fruit. They're not that much more than we in the Netherlands. So, and the same, of course, for the Netherlands. A lot of this is transit. But basically, all these countries are importing